everyone. Heather Earls here. Thanks for coming on today's episode. This week, like every week, I'll be talking about natural living and healthy tips that will get you to rethink how you live and what products or habits you can easily change to better your life. So let's get started. Hey everyone, today we're going to be talking about what are the health benefits of using a sauna. Now, according to Harvard Health publications, Mayans have used sweat houses as early as 3,000 years ago. Today, one in three Finns still use them. The citizens of the United States have also seen the benefits and have sold over 1 million to date. The majority of people use saunas for relaxation and cardiovascular health. Others use them to improve circulation. You can purchase a sauna or visit a bathhouse, gym, or spa who offer them to their paying customers. Now, for those of you who do not know, what is a sauna? Sauna is a heated room that holds a temperature between 70 to 100 Celsius or 158 to 212 degrees Fahrenheit and can raise your surface temperature or skin temperature from 40 Celsius or 104 Fahrenheit. Now, traditional Finnish saunas usually use dry heat with a relative humidity that is often between 10 and 20%. In other sauna types, the moisture is higher. Turkish-style saunas, for example, involve a greater level of humidity. That was by Medical News Today. Now, sweating can occur when your skin temperature rises and your heart rate will increase in an attempt to keep your body cool. Now, each person's body will lose a different amount of sweat depending on the time spent in the sauna and the overall shape of the body. So, let's get into types of saunas. And these types include a wood burning. Wood is used to heat the room or sauna rocks. Wood burning saunas are usually low in humidity and high in temperature. Then we have electrically heated. Like wood, electrically heated saunas have a low humidity and a high temperature. The electrical heater attached to the floor heats the sauna. Now there's infrared. Far infrared saunas are typically lower in temperature than other saunas. However, a person will still sweat as they do in a traditional type sauna. Special lamps use light waves to heat a person's body and not the entire room. The average infrared sauna is about 60 degrees Celsius. And then we have steam rooms. A steam room promotes sweating but uses high humidity and moist heat unlike your typical sauna. Some steam rooms also incorporate oil, which adds to the overall health benefits. Now, can saunas be harmful? Much of the information about sauna safety comes from Finland. A 16-month study of 1,631 heart attacks in Helsinki found that just 1.8% developed within 3 hours of taking a sauna. In another investigation of all 6,175 sudden deaths that occur in 1 year, only 1.7 occurred within 24 hours of taking a sauna, and many of these were related to alcohol. In Finland, taking saunas is a national pastime. So, do these results apply to people in other parts of the world who sometimes use saunas? Well, Canadian researchers investigated sauna safety in 16 patients with well-documented heart disease. They compared the effects of a 15-minute sauna with a standard treadmill stress test. None of the patients developed chest pain, abnormal heart rhythms, or ECG changes with either type of stress. Heart scans did show impaired blood flow to the heart muscles of most patients, but the sauna-induced changes were milder than the exercise-induced abnormalities. Now, saunas appear safe for patients with stable coronary heart disease. A small study from Japan suggested that 2 weeks of daily saunas may even improve vascular function in patients with mildly damaged hearts that cannot pump blood normally. This is stable heart failure. Still, heart patients should check with their doctors before using saunas. People who can perform moderate exercise, such as walking for 30 minutes or climbing 3 or 4 flights of stairs without stopping, will likely get an okay. But patients with poorly controlled blood pressure, abnormal heart rhythms, and advanced heart failure or heart valve disease will be advised to stay cool. Now, the sauna health benefits. Saunas produce a dry heat which has excellent effects on the body. Because the body temperature rises, your heart rate goes up and your pulse increases by about 30%. That means your blood is being circulated and pumped twice the average amount of times per minute. Circulation. Our bodies become alive when we have good circulation and blood flow. Every part functions and performs at a higher capacity, including your muscles, tendons, and joints, making the number one benefit of saunas the improvement of circulation. Internal cleaner. A second health benefit has to do with purifying your body. Human beings need to cleanse out harmful toxins inside of the body, and sweating is the best and most natural way to do that. Now, mixed with your sweat is a substance called urea, for which urine is named. In a paper published in the Journal of Biological Chemistry, researchers estimated up to 1.12 milligrams of urea is dissolved in every cubic centimeter of sweat. While this sounds like a small amount, the average person sweats up to 700 cubic centimeters of liquid each day, which means urea excreted in your sweat is responsible for up to 7% of your daily elimination of urea. Now, research has also determined that metals are excreted in measurable amounts, and many researchers, consider sweating a safe and effective way to eliminate arsenic, cadmium, lead, and mercury. Now, if you go to heatherearls.com/sauna, I will give a more in-depth explanation of how your sweat can clean out the toxins in your body. So let's move to skin. Your skin is one of your major organs and needs blood to survive. Since the use of sauna helps your blood flow, your skin will reap the benefits. Benefits like clean pores, a youthful glow, and a feeling of being refreshed. In short, the high heat, which promotes sweating, cleanses your body without the use of soaps and gives the appearance of younger-looking skin. Now, lung function. Breathing deeply in a sauna helps your lungs because the hot air opens them up and cleans them out. Certain oils can be added to the steam water to enhance this, like peppermint, eucalyptus, birch, and tea tree oil. Now, sickness. When you are sick and need to clear out your sinuses, adding oils such as eucalyptus can aid in the process. The congested feeling can be alleviated and the length of your symptoms reduced. Relaxation. The most enjoyable health benefit of a sauna is peace. People usually don't speak when using a sauna, allowing you to take some deep breaths, relax, de-stress, and gain a sense of well-being. All of these combined add to the health benefits of using a sauna. Now, a sauna is sterile. Saunas are self-sterilizing due to the high temperatures they reach, making them an ideal place for delivering babies and treating wounds at lower heat. This is a benefit that should not be overlooked, as achieving sanitary conditions can be very difficult, even in the modern hospitals. And that one is by Survival Blog. Now, we want to get into the health risks and precautions. First, dehydration can occur very quickly when using a sauna. While relaxing, we often forget to bring water in with us or step out for a second and take a drink. Drink 2 to 4 glasses of fresh water after each sauna. A person should avoid alcohol as it increases their chance of getting dehydrated. People with low blood pressure should consult with a doctor or time their sessions as one might become fatigued. Pregnant women should consult their doctor. Be sure to set a time so you don't fall asleep or stay in too long. If you are feeling overheated or fatigued, you need to get out and cool your body slowly. Avoid sauna use if ill. As I have a sauna in my home, I can attest to the benefits it offers for the whole family. However, if you're not sure a sauna is something you would enjoy, then go to your local gym or spa and try one before purchasing or building your own. Okay, you guys, that's all I have for you. I look forward to talking to you next week. Thanks for listening to today's episode of Urban Wisdom and Natural Living. Tune in next week, where I'll broadcast live every Monday morning at 8 a.m. If you miss it live, hold those tears and head on over to my blog, which is heatherearles.com. That's Heather, E-A-R-L-E-S.com. There you can have 24/7 access or right here on iTunes. If you want to follow me on social media, you'll find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and Pinterest. Have a healthy week.